Today, I will discuss about the factors affecting enzyme, which is a continuation part of yesterday. So up to now, we have studied the various enzyme substrate reaction scheme, the thermodynamic changes of various enzymes when it is reacting with the substrate, the protein folding nature, the effect of temperature on the enzyme, that is a denaturation thing by heating of the enzyme, the effect of temperature on the enzymatic reaction when it is reacting with the substrate, and after reacting, what is the optimum temperature and what is the denaturation step. Next, today I will start about the effect of substrate concentration. So here two, three factors we have discussed, that is the temperature, pH, and the enzyme substrate reaction. Here the effect of substrate concentration also playing a vital role. So we can see here at low substrate concentration, there are many active sites that are not occupied. This means the reaction rate is quite slow. That means when substrate is reacting with the enzyme, Here we can see that when substrate is reacting with the enzyme, as the substrate concentration is increasing, if temperature is constant, as the substrate concentration is increasing, that means what? Or the concentration of increase in substrate concentration, that means what? That means the increase, the velocity of the enzyme reaction. So if the substrate concentration is very high, it will react with the enzyme more and more. That means the reaction velocity to form the enzyme substrate complex is quite high. So this is the rate determining step, right? So again, I am going to this slide. Here we can see that when more substrate molecules are added, more enzyme substrate complex can be formed. So that is a normal phenomenon. As there are more active sites, if we know that the enzymes are having active site and binding site, if the enzymes having more active site, that means the rate of the reaction will also increase. Simultaneously, increasing of substrate concentration, what it will do? The active site will be saturated. So for that, if you are seeing this graph, it is an enzymatic activity we have plotted in x-axis, and the substrate concentration we have plotted in y-axis. So the effect of substrate concentration on the enzymatic activity, here we can see that increasing the substrate concentration means the increasing the rate of a reaction. So if I'm putting this graph at the optimum level, suppose here, you can see here red line, the dotted line, that is a maximum level, that is a maximum rate. So at the optimum concentration level, if you are adding more substrate, the all active site is fully blocked and working at the maximum efficiency. Afterwards, if you are adding in a substrate, means the reaction will stop. The enzyme substrate will not at all react in this optimum case. That means here the maximum rate is maximum, the velocity is maximum. Any increase in the concentration beyond this optimum level, here we can see that if you are increasing concentration, the line is coming straight. No effect is there. So there is no other extra active site present in the enzyme. Understand? So from this graph, we can conclude that if you are adding substrate, we are increasing substrate concentration gradually, the increase in the velocity of the reaction within a limit range, that is a maximum rate. Afterwards, if you're adding more and more substrate, there will be no change in the pattern. Graphical pattern is same. So the simultaneously the graph is going parallelly to the x-axis. So increasing in the substrate contents concentration, the all active site is engaged. So there is no further reaction will happen. Understand? Now, here some enzymatic activator and inhibitors also taking a part. So one more point is there, the presence of inhibitor and activators. So inhibitors means that will inhibit the enzymatic activity. And activator means it will activate. So what is the definition? Here we can see that enzymes, activators are chemical species that can bind with the enzyme and increases its activity. That means it is a type of chemical species that will bind with the enzyme and increases activity. Now we can see here. See, this is a right hand side. We can see it is the activator part. It will activate, it will bind to the site, enzymatic site, and the activation of the this site, activation of the substrate site means binding site. So if it is adding, then only the substrate binding site will activate and substrate will come and bind to the active site. So to increase the availability of the substrate binding, the activator is functioning here. Now, enzyme inhibitor. What do you mean by enzyme inhibitor? Enzyme inhibitors are chemical species that can bind with the enzyme to inhibit the reaction, to decrease the activity. So again, we are going here. Here, what happened? See, this is an inhibitor. If it is inhibitor, it's bind with the inhibitor site. So if you are binding means the substrate, see the conformation has changed. Here the conformation we can see, that is a lock and key model. But here the conformation has, substrate conformation has changed. So it will no longer will bind to the active site. So this is a function of the inhibitor. So the effect, what is the effect of the enzyme in case of inhibitor and activator? Obviously, this is a normal phenomena. We can understand by seeing this one, inhibitor will decrease the enzymatic activity as well as activator will increase the enzymatic activity. Here some examples, few examples are there. See, activators include hexokinase 1 and glucokinase that will activate the reaction. In presence of hexokinase and glucokinase, the reaction will be more fast. Enzymatic activity will be more. Simultaneously, some inhibitors are there. Ribonuclease inhibitor. Some drugs that will inhibit the reaction, the enzymatic reaction. That's why when doctors are prescribing something, some drugs, they're asking, okay, you are taking that drug. So do you have some immunological effect or do you have some allergic condition tendency? So this is because if you're taking the drug, simultaneously, if you are taking some food or something else, it will directly inhibit the digestion process. It will directly decrease the enzymatic activity of the digestive enzyme. Understand? So this is the influential factors. These are the all influential factors which we have discussed already, and today I have discussed some of the other factors, influential factors on the activity of the enzyme. Now, one more short thing I will conclude with this one. What is apoenzyme? Apoenzyme is nothing but an inactive enzyme. The activation of the enzyme occurs upon the binding of an organic and inorganic cofactor. So here we can see that is also acting as an activator, right? So apoenzyme, what do you mean by apoenzyme? It is an inactive enzyme. It is not activator. It is an enzyme. It is an inactive enzyme. So if you are binding with the enzyme, occurs upon binding, of an organic and inorganic cofactor. Here you can see that the metallic cofactor here is present. Here we can see a metallic cofactor. Here one coenzyme is there, and the metallic cofactor and coenzyme binds with the apoenzyme part. So this is the apoenzyme. Now, in that apoenzyme, cofactor is designated, in the enzyme, cofactor is designated as a apoenzyme. So some cases we can tell that the complex structure, the complete complex structure of a protein with all necessary small organic molecules, metal ions and other compounds is termed as holoenzyme. So you can see what is holoenzyme. Here protein chains are there, active sites are there, some cofactors also present there. So that is a holoenzyme, right? Next, I will move to the active site. So here we can see that the enzyme molecule binds, contains some, binds with the substrate molecule. Where it will bind, the binding site we have to identify. So in that enzyme or in the substrate, substrate entering to the enzyme site. So this is an enzyme. This is an enzyme. Here two sites are there. One is active site and one is binding site. So substrate will come and bind with the enzyme, okay, and form the enzyme substrate complex. Naturally, enzyme substrate complex will turn, changes to the shape slightly, and substrate binds more compactly. Substrate will bind with the enzymatic site. Then after that, products leaving the substrate and product is formed and from the enzyme. From the enzyme substrate complex, an enzyme is intact and substrate is there and product is formed. Understand, this is a nature of the active site, right? So today this is a whole thing I have discussed. If you're having any query, any doubt, you can feel free to ask me. Okay, thank you.